Hi friends, today we are going to learn Python. So let's learn history. So there are history of Python. So there are few points I have noted, just simple. So Python was created on late 1980s. So in 1980s, it was first conceived by Godot van Rossum. I don't know if my pronunciation is correct. So yeah, so Godot has conceived on 1980s, but it got released on 1981. Then they released the 2.0 version of Python on 2000, and it goes and they introduced few new features in this version, and it so the 2x version discontinued in 2020. So the last version was 2.7. So just recently it got discontinued. So parallelly, they have launched Python 3 version on 2008, and the current version is 3.9.1 when I am recording this video, and this is the first version which supporting macOS Sur, macOS 11 Sur. Okay, so those who are using the macOS, so they can know it. So the difference between Python 3 and Python 2 is that Python 3 is not backward compatibility. So whatever you are written in Python 2 already, if you have any project on Python 2, then it will not run on the Python 3. So that is a problem actually. So Python 3 is not backward compatibility. So it was a little bit history of the Python, when it was got created and what is the current version going on. So the design philosophy I see in the actually Wikipedia, the design philosophy of Python, so which actually looks nice, so I can read it out. So the beautiful is better than ugly, explicit is better than implicit, simple is better than complex, so complex is better than complicated, readability counts. So these were their design philosophy, which is actually looks good in the philosophy. Okay, so this is the philosophy of Python design, what the developer have their philosophy in mind. These are the points. So yeah, so this is real time points actually, you can say. Then I have few points that why we should learn Python. So the first thing is simple and easy to learn. So Python is very simple and easy to learn. You can learn easily. It is English like language. So the syntax are not complex, not clutter. If you compare with Java, there are no semicolon, there are no curly braces. So it will be well aligned. If it is not well aligned, then it will not compile basically. So the code is well aligned. So it's simple, easy, and not clutter. Learning is also easy. Then second is it is portable and extensible. Portable means you can use the Python in other OS, in any OS basically, like Windows, Linux, and other OS which are available. And extensible in the meaning you can call Python API from the existing languages like Java, C++. So there are many hooks which can be used to call the Python API. So it is extensible. Then it is web development. You can develop well-designed web pages using the Python. So there are Django framework which is being used to design the web. So there are REST API also you can develop using the Python. And AI. So AI is the vast area which is going on now in the market. So all the applications which using AI are, so basically AI applications are being coded with Python. Python is being used because it has huge library. You can use mathematical library design your requirement, your right to write your logic. So that's why it is so much used in AI. Then big data, so there is PySpark is there. So this is, you can write the code in Python, and so dedicated PySpark is there, so you can use it in big data area also. Then scripting and automation. So scripting and automation means nowadays the rapid development is going on, so the DevOps engineer are using the scripting language, Python scripting language, to automate their build and deploy to the production. So directly they can automate the build, deploy to the production. So it helps, so it minimizes the human error and deployment fast. So that's why Python is being used. Then data science, so it has used, as I told before, it has used mathematical libraries, so which are being used to use in the data science area. Then the most important thing is there are vast community. So the community is very fast and very supportive, so they can support you if you facing any issues. And the last thing is the demand. So as there are many requirement, many application are getting developed, because see, there are many area where the Python is getting used, like scripting, DevOps, then AI, then big data, web development, and data science. So there are many area where one language is being used, so it is very benefit for Python, those who knows the Python. So the demand is high because it is being used in multiple areas, so the job opportunities are also high. So that's why we should learn Python. And yes guys, so these are the points which I got, that why we should learn Python. There are many more points, so these are just few points I highlighted, that why we should learn Python. So let's see what are the software requires for installation of the Python and how we can code with the Python. I think we can learn that one in the next class. So for today, this much. So today this much. Thank you guys, please subscribe to the channel.